Kalthum says, one of the permissible ways to make wasila for the acceptance of dua is of our good deeds, like if I have an exam, I say, oh Allah, make me pass the exam through the good deed. Suppose I gave sadaqah to someone and I pass exam. So the question would be, after a few years, I need a job. Can I make wasila of the same good deed that I used in a previous dua? Will it be accepted, or one good deed with pure intention works only for one time? This is only in Allah's hands. Wasila is asking Allah Azza wa Jal to make something happen through three things, as the scholars say. The first thing is to ask Allah through His beautiful names and attributes. Like saying, oh Allah, I ask you that you are Allah, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Malik, Al-Quddus. I ask you that you are Al-Aziz, Al-Ghafoor, Al-Muhaymin, that you do so and so for me. And this is legit by the consensus of scholars. The second type is to ask Allah Azza wa Jal through your own good deeds. Meaning that previously you had done something sincerely for the sake of Allah, and now in times of crisis, you ask Allah. Like the story of the three people who were trapped in a cave, where a big rock fell on the entrance and blocked them from going out. Three of them started to supplicate to Allah by a good deed they did in the past. One said, I was dutiful to my parents by not sleeping the whole night while holding a vessel of milk until they woke up. The other one said, I was keeping my promise and doing my dues to a worker who worked for me and left without getting paid. I invested his wage and it multiplied until it became a fortune. Years later, he came and asked for his day wage, and I gave him all these camels and cows and sheep and wealth and slaves, and he took it and left. The third one supplicated with his chastity, where he refrained from committing fornication because of the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah answered all of their supplications and prayers and removed the rock away. So this is the second type of wasila. The third type of wasila is to ask Allah through the dua of righteous people. So I know of a scholar, I know of an imam, and I go and visit the imam and I say to him, Akhi, I've got debts on me, I have problems, so ask Allah for me to pay off my debts, for example. This is totally permissible and legit, because the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam used to pray for his companions, and also asking living individuals to pray for you is permissible. What is not permissible is to go to graveyards, to go to the deceased and call them to ask Allah for something, when we know that they're dead and they cannot do anything for you. So coming back to Kalthum's question, the answer would be, yes, you can ask Allah to make you pass the exam because, or through the charity you had given, the sadaqah you had given for His sake. Now, can you use this over and over again? This is in Allah's hands. You can use it as many as you wish, but will Allah answer it or not? This is only in Allah's knowledge And Allah Azza wa Jal knows best.